Hi guys, so I wasn't planning on getting any new tarantulas for a while because I'm actually selling some and making some space for my breeding projects that I've got going on at the minute. But yeah, I saw that the spider shop had some subadult Mexican red knees in and I asked them if they had a male and they said they did, so decided to buy it. And also, as well as the male, I decided to get a little spiderling as well, so you can see just how small they are when they start out. So yeah, got the enclosure set up ready for the subadult male and also for the small spiderling. So I'll get them open and show them to you. Okay then guys. Okay, so here's the subadult male. I think he's got another 2 or 3 molts before he matures out. So if I don't get a mature male before this guy matures out, then that's when the breeding project will be starting for the Mexican red knees. And over here, this little dot over here, is the spiderling. I'll just change the focus so we can get a better view of him. Okay, so there he is. He's only got about a centimetre leg span, and that's how small the brachypelmas start out. Okay then guys, now let's get him into their new enclosures. Okay, so there's the male into his new enclosure. I've just measured his leg span and he's 4 inches. So I'm thinking maybe just 1 or 2 months before he matures, which will be in about 1 or 2 years time. So yeah. That's my male that I've got. Now let's go do the spiderling. Okay guys, so before we do the spiderling, looks like the male is thirsty, as he's now taking a drink from his water bowl. Yeah, this is the first time I've caught this on camera, so it's quite interesting to see if you've not seen it before. They just literally submerge the mouth parts into the water and take it up. Not something they do very often, but it is quite cool to catch them in the act. Okay then guys, now let's go do that spiderling. Okay, so there's the spiderling in its new enclosure, and as you can see, even this tiny enclosure looks a little bit too big for it, but no doubt it'll grow pretty quickly, and then I'll be rehousing it in a few months. So yeah. Now I'm going to show you a few molts that I've got in the collection. My M. balfouri and also my Asian aculeata. So first up is my Asian aculeata, the Brazilian giant white knee. And as you can see, she has now completely regenerated her leg and now you can't even tell which one was missing. And there's the molt over there. But yeah, that's great news that she's fully regenerated her legs. Well, I say her, but it's probably a male because it is growing quite fast. There's the old carapace over there. Compared to the size of the new one, there's a big difference in size. And the other spider to molt is my M. balfouri. I don't know where the molt is, it's in this massive web somewhere. But yeah, there's the M. balfouri. You can't really see the colours through the camera because the lid's still on. I'm going to try and take it off and hopefully he won't run and hide away. Okay, so it's good news. He's decided to stay out in the open and you can really see the blue on the legs now and the kind of metallic-y silver carapace. There's also the bright cream coloured femurs on the legs. So yeah, pretty much the adult colours already. And he's only 2.5 inches. So I'm very glad that I decided to get this spider. And I'm also quite lucky that he's decided to start in the open most of the time. He kind of makes his web all above ground, which is not what I expected. But yeah, so all I am good news. Okay then guys, I think that's about it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed watching, and I will see you again soon.